Hello everyone and welcome back to elearnmarkets.com YouTube channel. Well, of course, we take loans for several purposes, maybe a home loan or for buying a motor vehicle, etc. And we have to pay that amount into installments. Of course, that installment amount carries two elements, which is principal and interest. Now, in our blog write-ups, if you will see on our website, we have written as to what is EMI and how do we calculate it. But practically in this video, we will understand as to how to calculate the repayment schedule, that is the equated monthly payment schedule. So let us understand quickly with the help of an Excel sheet. Let us understand the calculation of EMI with the help of Excel sheet. Suppose the loan amount here is 2 lakh rupees. The tenure of loan, that is the time within which you have to pay the loan, is 1 year and you pay monthly for it. So the number of payments per year is 12. Suppose the rate of interest is 18%. So this rate of interest is per annum. We will calculate the rate of interest per month, which is 18% divided by 12. Now the next question is, how do we calculate the monthly payment? Monthly payment is the function of PMT. So if you type PMT on the Excel, open the bracket, you will see the following features on your Excel sheet. So this is the rate. For that you need to click on the rate, comma. Next is the NPER, which means number of payments. Next is the present value of the loan taken, comma type, which can be kept as 0, and then the bracket is to be closed. You will see that the balance that comes in is a negative figure. This is because the payment is an outflow and the money will go out of your pockets, and that is the reason that it amounts to a negative figure. Alternatively, if you put a negative sign over here, the figure will come as positive. So that is what our monthly installment amount is. Now, how do we calculate our balances and the EMI statement? As you can see on the screen, that we have made 5 columns, which comprises of number of payments, monthly installment, interest amount, principal amount, and the balance due. So we begin with the 0th year, that is today our balance amount to be paid is rupees 2 lakh. Now on the first year, our monthly installment, which is to be paid, is rupees 18,336, as we calculated above. Now the interest amount will be the balance outstanding multiplied by the rate of interest as calculated here. Press enter and you will get the interest amount. Principal amount will be the monthly installment figure minus the interest that we calculated just now, and the answer will be the principal figure. Now the balance due will be the outstanding amount at the beginning of previous year reduced by the principal amount, and that is the balance due for the next year. When you continue this process for the remaining 11 to 12 months, you will see that at the end of 11th year, the amount outstanding will come to rupees 18065.02. Now on the 12th year, what you need to do is put the total outstanding amount on the 11th year at the column of principal on the 12th year as shown on the screen. The difference between the monthly installment amount and the principal amount will be the interest amount, which is also said to be the balancing figure. The resultant balance will be 0. So this implies that the loan amount taken by you at the rate of 18% per annum is paid in such a method by following the Excel sheet pattern. So now you have your own Excel sheet, your own repayment schedule that you have prepared, and now you know beforehand that how much amount you will require to pay for your loan. Like if it is monthly or if it is quarterly or if it is yearly, you know that how much amount of income you have to keep aside for the installment payment, and you can calculate it with your own self. In case you like the video, do press the like button. In case of any queries or questions or suggestions, please mention in the comment box below. Thank you for staying connected with us. Happy learning.